This vintage original poster is from 1971, and it was suffering from heavy folio creases. Watch how we flattened it out through linen backing today on Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix. Today you're going to see how linen backing can flatten out a poster that has very sharp folio creases in it. The show is Follies, and the artist is Bird. Take a look. This is a rather large poster, originally intended to be a three sheet. It only has the larger of the sheets, which is enough to make a full poster. The folio creases are very heavy, very sharp. They will be flattened out, however, today. Matt is preparing this screen with acid-free paper by having mounted it to the cotton canvas. He's now getting it wet so that it will expand and be ready to receive this Broadway poster for Follies. Follies is a musical with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim and a book by James Goldman.
Face up.
The plot takes place in a crumbling Broadway theater now scheduled for demolition, previously home to a musical revue based on the Ziegfeld Follies. The evening follows a reunion of the Weissman girls who performed during the interwar period.
It says paste
here. Yeah, there should be another section, but he didn't send me another section. What they would probably put is the venue. They would put the name of the theater up here, but he didn't send me another sheet. Okay. I'm hoping that having a new person in the shop will make my ratings go up.
Probably.
The original Broadway production, directed by Harold Prince and Michael Bennett, with choreography by Bennett, opened April 4th, 1971. The musical was nominated for 11 Tony Awards and won 7. The original production, among the most costly on Broadway, ran for over 500 performances, but ultimately lost its entire investment. The musical has had a number of major revivals, and several of its songs have become standards, including Broadway Baby, I'm Still Here, Too Many Mornings, Could I Leave You, and Losing My Mind. Scenic design by Boris Aronson, costumes by Florence Klotz, and lighting by Theron Musser. It starred Alexis Smith, John McMartin, Dorothy Collins, Gene Nelson, along with several veterans of the Broadway and vaudeville stage. The supporting role of Carlotta was created by Yvonne DiCarlo. Other notable performers in the original productions were Fifi Dorsay, Justine Johnston, and Mary McCarty. The show closed July 1st, 1972, after 522 performances and 12 previews. According to Variety, the production was, quote, total financial failure, with a cumulative loss of $792,000. Harold Prince planned to present the musical on the West Coast and then on a national tour. However, the show did not do well in its Los Angeles engagement, and plans for a tour ended.
We've been lucky today. We haven't had any big pace bumps. Mm-hmm. Whenever I work alone, I have them a lot. They're a real pain. Yeah, there's an air pocket there. Push that again, roll it again. Sponge.
This Follies poster is linen backed, and we're going to let it dry for a couple of days before we trim it down and then do the color touch-up. You won't want to miss that, so don't go away. Incidentally, if you have any questions about the restoration and linen backing of your vintage posters, you can get in touch with me at this email address on the screen or give me a call at that phone number. Tell me something about your posters, tell me their size, tell me their condition, and send me a few photos if you can. Whatever you can tell me is helpful, and I'll get back to you with recommendations for restoration and a price. Until then, I look forward to seeing your posters. We're back in the Poster Fix shop. Well, a few days have passed. The poster is dry, and it's time to trim it down and touch it up. Let's talk about the artist, David Bird. Incidentally, this Follies poster is sharing the screen with four World War II era posters. You will see these posters covered in a future video. They concern the use of cotton in the war. I'm trimming the border to leave 1/2 inch all around. This poster was designed by David Bird, and he was born in 1941, and he's an American graphic artist, designer, illustrator, and painter. Many of his designs are considered to have helped define the look of rock and roll music starting in the 1960s. He is most well known for his poster designs, including his rock posters for the Fillmore East, as well as his Broadway theater posters. Among other Broadway shows, he did Godspell, The Robber Bridegroom, The Grand Tour, The Survival of St. Joan, Jesus Christ Superstar, and Little Shop of Horrors, among others. In 1976, David Bird illustrated the cover of the first edition of Christopher Street Magazine, the first gay literary magazine. From 1984 to 86, he was art director of the national gay news magazine, The Advocate. In 1973, David Bird, along with several other prominent illustrators, received a Grammy Award for the album design and packaging of Tommy by The Who. In 2007, the Ringling College of Art and Design presented a retrospective of the work of David Bird. There's very good reading about David Bird in Michael Patrick's book, The Art of the Broadway Poster. In 1969, David Bird created the original poster for Woodstock, but as the festival was subsequently moved, and Bird, then on vacation on the Caribbean island of St. Martin, could not be reached, his original design went unused. And now we're getting into the final stage of the restoration of this Broadway Follies poster. To do the touch-up, I'm using a combination of watercolor markers and watercolor pencils to match the color and fill in these areas. These materials are water-reversible. Apart from these fold lines, the condition of this poster is remarkably good, and the linen backing has come out fabulously. I hope you enjoyed watching us linen back this Broadway show poster. Remember, at Poster Fix, we love to bring your vintage posters back to life.